Yo,
it's been a minute since we had our last Q&A, so Q&A, roll it. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Channel's name is The Third Ernest. I'm Ernest Adiano, The Third. Y'all guys are The Third Family. If you're new here and you're not subscribed, you like what you see at the end of the video, consider becoming part of the family, clicking the subscribe button bottom right-hand corner. Now, since my last Q&A that I did, I think I only did one or two of them. I said I was going to do them every month, but then I got sidetracked with, you know, medical emergencies and the family emergencies. And then I was like, a lot of new music and I wanted the channel to grow. So I stopped doing Q&As when I said that I would. But now that we have 76,000 subscribers, I really appreciate it. Obviously, it's not the most subscriber count of all time, but every single subscriber matters. And since there's a lot of new fam here, I thought what better time to do a Q&A than right now. So for future reference, if you wanna ask a question and potentially get an answer, there's three places to do it. The only one that you're guaranteed to get your question on the video is Patreon. The second one is gonna be in the Discord. There's a Discord channel specifically for Q&A. And then also if I throw it on the gram like I did today. And all three of these are linked down below. Let's get it. First question comes from the longtime channel supporter and Patreon supporter, Grace. Grace has been on the channel since before 1,000 subscribers. That's like super duper OG when the channel barely had any kind of identity. It wasn't really a reaction channel just yet. It was just a drunk reaction at that point. So Grace, I appreciate all your support and your Patreon subscription. You were the very first one on Patreon. I really appreciate that. But she says, who's your favorite comedian currently? Jerry Seinfeld is always gonna be my all-time favorite comedian. Then we have Sebastian Maniscalco. The dude is just funny. Like everything, his storytelling capability is amazing. The way he moves is like his facial features, the way that he moves on stage, the amount of like exaggeration that he has on stage, everything about it is great. And it's pretty clean for the most part. And then third, Nate Bargatze, the dude's just dry. His storytelling is just so dry and the jokes just come out of nowhere. They land and it's just like his whole body language on stage is like, I guess I'm good at this, but whatever. So those are my three at top right now. With an honorable mention for Bo Burnham. He would be up there, but his last special wasn't for like 3-4 years. So he's up there as well. It just takes a lot longer for him to come out with a special. Next, we got Lorenzo Baca. Again, he's a Patreon subscriber. I appreciate it, Lorenzo. If you've not subscribed anymore, I appreciate the time that you had on there. If you are subscribed, big ups to you, bro. He said, if I sent you a beat that I made, would you write a rap over it? I mean, I would, I could. Send it away, throw it in the DMs. Vigilante K9 is the next one. He said, just join the Patreon here, so if I don't know if you've talked about this in the past, but are you a gamer and what games do you play if you are? I wouldn't consider myself a gamer per se, but I do like playing video games. Obviously, Call of Duty, the new Modern Warfare is amazing. My favorite video game probably in terms of like playing it over and over is the Uncharted series and The Last of Us. Basically any Naughty Dog like game studio video game, I'm about it. Then we obviously have like Super Mario and all the Nintendo video games because those are just fun to play. But if we're talking about a serious video game, The Last of Us is probably my favorite video game of all time. Zero to Infinity, another subscriber. I still need to get to his Dan Bull request. I gotta get that, man, I swear. And he says, yeah, I don't know if I asked about movies. What's your favorite movies and which ones do you like? What's your favorite animated movie? Favorite animated movie? Probably Ratatouille. You were probably thinking Coco, right? You racist, stereotypical motherfuckers. Nah, just kidding. But yeah, I think Ratatouille is like the underrated goat of Pixar. For sure, my all-time favorite movie, Good Will Hunting. No doubt about it. The performance, the fact that Matt Damon, also one of the goats, sleeping underrated goat of our time, Matt Damon. Him, he wrote it at Harvard and it was just like an assignment and then it turned into this Emmy award-winning, Golden Globe award-winning like movie. And then Will comments right under that, another Patreon subscriber, and if you have any, what director styles do you like the most? Always appreciate your perspective on perspective. I always appreciate your perspective on my perspective of perspective. So, back at you. But favorite director at the moment, Quentin Tarantino's directing style and just everything about the way he holds suspense and the way he can capture certain ways that other people can't, dope. And then right now, if we're talking director, probably Clint Eastwood. Clint Eastwood's mood, his color grading, the way he moves the camera, the way he tells the story through the camera, dope. Next, we got Kelly, 30 Seconds to Mars. Kelly here, she is also a longtime Patreon, also a longtime channel subscriber, but also one of the two moderators for the Discord. So if you wanna hop in Discord, we're all active in there. I'm telling you, Discord's fire. And she says, can you show us the sweet puppy? Is she napping on the couch today? Actually, she's at my dad's right now because I work, but here's a couple pictures of her. Boom, 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 boom. There you go. There she is. I'll put her in the video next video. Next, we got Hannah Kate, another longtime subscriber, another longtime Patreon supporter. But Hannah here is Discord's counselor slash psychiatrist. The whole reason that I did the last like 16 personalities quiz was because of Hannah. And she says, what's your favorite day of the year? I'm not sure. It's probably Christmas Eve, Christmas Day. I have a divorced family, so everybody has like different times, but even the divorced sides of the family. My family's divorces are super clean. Everybody's BFFs, everybody talks to each other. The ex-husbands talk to the current husbands, ex-wives talk to the current wives and their family and yada, yada, yada. So on Christmas Eve and Christmas Day, everybody gets together and we just get fucked up. In the name of Jesus, can I get an amen? Nah, but really, it's just like, I'm around a lot of family that I really don't get to see. My brother has a lot of friends that are basically like family members. They come over all the time. They're basically his brothers. So they come over when they're done with their family. Christmas is dope. Christmas is definitely where it's at for me. Not to mention A Christmas Story 24/7 on TBS. That shit's live. Next, we got Josh Pierce, and I don't know who is still supporting the Patreon, but at one time, if you're not on there anymore, I appreciate it. But Josh says, would you listen to CHH if it was hard as fuck? And CHH is Christian hip hop. I most definitely would. I've been like, Andy Mineo is like my boy right now. He actually tweeted me out and he put me on his story on Instagram. Lecrae just dropped some new shit, so I gotta check it out. The way that they do their style of Christian hip hop, it's not very preachy. It's just telling the raw emotions of what a mortal person feels who looks up to something bigger than him. Like, that's what I like to see. That's what I like to hear. That's dope. Grace, again, you got another question in, but I'm gonna go ahead and answer it real quick. Do you have any technical certs like CompTIA, A+, or networking? No certifications, no degrees, no nothing. Your boy just out here fucking winging it. And then we got Kelly again. Are you thinking of watching The Mandalorian? This is how long ago that was, when Mandalorian had all the hype. I have not subscribed to Disney Plus, but I do want to watch Mandalorian. Next, we have Daniel Hamdar. Daniel Hamdar says, how has YouTube changed your life since you blew up? I wouldn't say that I've blown up. I've gotten more subscribers than I ever thought that I've got, but I wouldn't say blown up. What do your parents think of your reactions when they watch them? I mean, it's not their music, so it's not their type of music to understand. Like, but yes, all of my family is extremely supportive. They were obviously kind of skeptical at first when I was putting in a lot of work into it, like not seeing anybody, not going over, not seeing my friends. Now that I'm sort of reaping the benefits of all that hard work at the very beginning, they're like, oh, okay, we understand now. So yeah, my fam's supportive, but I don't think it's changed me in any way. I joke like I'm a Z-list YouTube celebrity, but I mean, I'm still the same person. David Mike, who I know is still on Patreon. David, I appreciate you. I think he's in the Discord as well. How did you become so well-versed in video production techniques and in-depth lyricism? I've always thought about not what's being said or not what's being directed or not what we're looking at. What I think about is, how did they come to this moment? How did the director choose that this is the angle, with this is the lens, this is the way the camera's gonna move? How did he choose all that compared to all the other options that he had? I'm not completely engulfed in the movie. I'm also thinking about the production behind the scenes as the movie is going on. Like, how did they get this shot? Why did they choose this angle? Why is the film color graded in this way? Why did the editor go with this pace? That's how I got so well versed, because I'm looking for all of that stuff. And in terms of lyricism, I don't know. I've just always had that knack. I guess it's because I'm a good writer. I write extremely well. So understanding the way that lyricists flip words and flip meanings and flip phrases, like, all that stuff has just come natural to me. And it might be because I'm a good writer myself. But that's a really good question. Next, we have Rini666. Rini is the other moderator of the Discord. She and Kelly are the two moderators, and then there's one like technical support for them named Foul. If you could mask together any specific aspects of different artists' talents and then create the dream track, what talents would you choose? What artists would you choose? Girl, you're asking questions that I don't even know the answer to. Lupe's Fiasco swag, his swag, his tone of voice, everything about it. He knows he's the GOAT. Beat wise, I don't know, because now we're talking about like, who's my favorite producer? I would probably go either J Dilla. I would go Just Blaze. Maybe even DJ Premier. That's the sound that I like. Even Kanye West. If Kanye West produced it, I'm fine with that. And if I'm being completely honest, I would actually want like serious Lil Dicky on the track, because that dude has fucking bars. But that's a super tough question. If I thought about it for 10 minutes, the answer would probably change, to be honest. But so I don't know. I really don't know on that one. I'm gonna have to get back with you on that one. Hannah Kate again. What's your favorite Christmas present you've ever received and your favorite one ever given? Honestly, don't remember Christmas presents. I don't remember material things too well. I would probably say my favorite Christmas present that I've gotten is, I would probably say my first camera, like my first full-fledged like SLR camera. SLR, not even digital SLR, SLR with film, 35 millimeter film. It was a Konica Minolta. That's probably my favorite because that's what got me kind of into photography and into this video world that I'm in right now. And then the favorite Christmas gift I've ever given, I honestly don't know because I think I got my brother one of the iPhones one time. I don't remember exactly what I got him, but it was definitely something that I gave to my brother. But again, I don't remember those things. I'm not one to remember individual, just kind of like the whole memory. Next, we got Vinny. Vinny's in the Discord and his name changes every like month. We had Light Mode Vinny because he was the one that used Light Mode in Twitter and Light Mode on YouTube. And then we had Fresh Fade Vinny because he went to a new barber and the barber fucked his shit up. So we called him Fresh Fade Vinny. But he says, what do the Spurs have to do to start winning? Well, first off, the season's done for right now. But I think Pop needs to change his whole style. To be honest, I think Pop needs to retire. Well, he's probably the GOAT coach, like the best coach of all time. I would put him even above Phil Jackson, but I just think it's time for him to pass the torch, especially with what happened with Kawhi Leonard going down. The team has never gathered and kind of we never re-gelled. And some of his lineups and his decision-making and who's in and who's out, it's not like, I just don't agree with it. So I think he's gotta go, gotta pass the torch to either Tim Duncan or to Becky Hamm. And then we just need to get our shit together is really all it comes down to. This next one is an old question from Christian Bass, so it really doesn't pertain anymore. He says, how often will you drop M's new albums? Like, how many times will I react? I'm pretty much done reacting to Eminem's album. There might be like little one-offs. I know everybody's asking for Little Engine. Those kind of nights, I already heard it and I don't really like it. I don't really like M and Ed together other than the River track. When M went on Ed's track with 50 Cent, I thought that track was garbage. So other than a couple one-offs, I'm probably done reacting to the album. But that's it for all the Patreon questions. Let's see if we can knock out some of these Instagram questions here. Let's see how many I got here. Well, I got a lot more than I thought I was gonna get. Look, this is the top right here. You see it? Like, bruh. All right, we'll answer the good ones. BRaymond89, why did you start your reaction channel? Two, do you check your DMs? I really don't check my DMs that often. It's kind of exhausting, like going through. Right now I have like 99 plus. If I try to go through all of them, it would take me hours. And he said, why did you start your reaction channel? I didn't know that that's what I wanted to do when I started the channel. I initially did it just to get creativity out of my body, like through video form, make my friends laugh, you know, me laugh, my family laugh at the vlog and stuff. And then I saw a reaction one day after Eminem put out The Ringer, and I was drunk. I've told the story before. My three-year-old, I think she was turning three, my goddaughter, we had her birthday at a Mexican restaurant and I was gone off the mark, son. And then I came home and I was like, I could fucking do this. Nobody's ever even breaking down the bars. Like, are they going over people's heads or not? Maybe they're getting it, they're just not mentioning it. So I'm like, let me mention it. So I went in, I did it, and then I got good feedback, and then Killshot was released like right after that. That got like the most views and the most subscribers I ever seen at one time. And then the search, like a couple months after that, and then that got me crazy subscribers for the time. Like I was getting over 100 a day when normally I was getting 2 or 3 a day. And that was my first video that hit 100,000 views. So that's when I decided like maybe I'm filling a lane that is not filled in this YouTube world with breakdowns. I was actually providing substance, not only to people that watch the reaction channel, like that like rap, but I get a lot of people from like across the world saying, bro, English is not my first language and you helped me understand this song so much better because you broke it down in a way that I could understand, because I don't get the nuances of, you know, double entendres and flipping words and wordplay the English language because I don't have a grasp on it like that. I was like, oh shit, I'm actually helping people enjoy music more. So that's when I started to like, okay, this is what I'm gonna do with my channel. A little long-winded, but that's what happened. J053ALV, he says, what do you do for a living besides YouTube, of course? Bro, YouTube is not my living whatsoever. I make 90% of the money that I make on YouTube comes directly from the Patreon because I do get hit with a lot of copyright claims. The label takes all of the money from the video because I'm using a copyrighted song. Even if I technically am using it in a fair use way, you know, I'm not just stealing a view from the video. People are coming to my video for my analysis versus for the actual track. They still use it because I'm using their copywritten material. But what I do to support my bills and to support my life away from this, I'm a banker and I'm actually in the process of getting a Series 7 and Series 66 license to become a licensed wealth financial advisor, wealth manager. So that's what I do. Quick one right here, Rebecca Shirk 7, what video editing software do you prefer? Premiere Pro. And the reason I prefer it might not be the best, it might have a couple bugs here and there, but I prefer it because I use Lightroom and I use Photoshop a lot for the, for my photography, and it all comes in a bundle package. So Zezoka, if I'm pronouncing that right, .39, are you hyped for Logic's next album? Not at all. He's got a lot to live up to, and you know, at this point, the further that he digs himself in the hole, the harder it's gonna be for him to get out. But so he's gotta come with some shit. It's gotta be like under pressure good in order for me to be hyped for it. Sugar_lips84, how is your brother doing? He's doing great. For those of you that don't know, my brother had VFib. He had an episode of VFib playing basketball, his first game of his senior year in college. He put a defibrillator put in. There's a video on it if y'all wanna, you know the story. But then right after that, like a couple months after that, just a month ago, he had a collapsed lung out of nowhere. But he's all better now, he's good. My boy Hollywood Hector, son, when will we have a drink? Bro, as soon as coronavirus is over, as soon as they open up 210, we there. We throwing back some lukewarm beer and eating some wings. I'll even pay for it. I got you. Optional_0, have you ever noticed that NF's second verse is always weaker than the first one lyrically? I haven't noticed that, but I guess, you know, it's hard to write a second verse. It's hard to beat the first one a lot of times, but I would actually say that Pay My Dues had the better last verse than the first part of the song when he's going on the offbeat flow. I'll pay attention for that though. I never thought about that. I am Jerry 12, my boy Jerry. I used to work with this dude at Cornerstone Home Lending. Saw him at the bar the other day. He's like, yo, bro, I fucking love your success. And I'm like, I appreciate you, bro. I know that you truly mean it. So he said, when do you think restaurants will be open again? Coronavirus! I would probably say like in a month, but who knows on actual food, because a lot of things can be transmitted through food, and that's probably, obviously, that's how coronavirus came about. So the food industry is probably gonna be extremely regulated now. WheezyMo_, favorite 21 Pilots music video. I haven't seen them all because I still got the Trench Trilogy coming up. Fluorine is actually probably my favorite 21 Pilots song in general because of the very end where he goes into the breakdown about the a weathered flag at the sea. That's fucking tight. But the new video that they just put out that I did a video on, that one was sick. ISAO Potato said, if you could listen to only one artist, who would it be? I always say Lupe Fiasco because there's actually enough there for me to like listen to and break down and understand and appreciate in terms of lyricism and song conceptualization of the song. Eminem obviously has a crazy extensive long category that I couldn't get tired of just because of how long it is. It would honestly probably be one of those two. If Andre 3000 had an entire solo album, it would probably be that too. And I'm completely butchering people's usernames on IG, so my bad, but Muji Africa, are you married? Do you live alone? What do you do for a living? Already answered the what do I do for a living. Am I married? Nope, don't even have a girlfriend. Do I live alone? Yes, with my dog and Cheddar the cat that's always with the beef out the window. That's him sneezing in the background. Chris AOD said, when is your EP dropping? Bro, it's not dropping. I might put some shit that I've done in the past here and there, but I haven't written anything in a very long time. It's fun though, it was fun to write. I might just pick it up and get back on it. But that's pretty much it for today's video, ladies and gentlemen. I'm probably gonna have to break these videos into a couple parts because I got way more questions than I anticipated. I thought I was gonna get maybe like 15, 20 questions. Nah, I got like fucking 300. So if I didn't get to your question, it might be because it was a duplicate or you sent me more than one question and I picked the best one out of the questions. I couldn't answer all the questions more than once. But I appreciate everybody that sat here and watched the whole thing. I appreciate everybody that interacted and gave me questions to be able to put onto the video. If you want to be guaranteed that your question is going to get answered, hit up the Patreon and give a little donation, because that unlocks the ability to ask questions for the next Q&A that are guaranteed going to be answered. If you want to do a little less guarantee, something that's free, hit up the Discord, because the Discord has a whole Q&A channel where I'm going to eventually start picking questions off of the Discord directly. That'll probably be two Q&As from now, because this Q&A is gonna expand over two questions, over two videos. But hit up the Discord, hit up Twitter, hit up the Instagram, all links in the description below. Instagram is how I got the questions right here, so that was how I did it this time. But next time it's pretty much gonna exclusively be Patreon, Discord. But like I always say, I appreciate everybody's time and I hope this was as entertaining for you as it was for me. It was really fun making this video. I like answering questions and interacting with y'all guys. So if that's something that you enjoyed, consider subscribing if this is your first time here. That's pretty much it for today's video, ladies and gentlemen. Like I always say at the end of all of my videos, go out there in the world, love and care for one another, love and care for each other. And I'll catch everybody in the next video. Peace.